Hi guys, it's Adam and welcome to my latest cryptocurrency video. So today what we're going to discuss, and I apologize in advance, I've got a bit of a sore throat, so I apologize about in advance, but what we're going to discuss today is cryptocurrency and tax with relation to the UK. So I'm involved with a lot of Facebook groups, cryptocurrency Facebook groups. I talk to a lot of people about cryptocurrency on a daily basis, and I've seen a lot of confusion really with taxation on cryptocurrency and things like that, and it is a very, very new thing, so obviously it can be quite hard to define taxation and what you need to be doing and what you need to be declaring and how you need to be going about declaring it and stuff. I want to first state as well, before we get onto the video, the bulk of the video, I'm not a certified accountant or anything like that, so it's always worth taking misinformation with a pinch of salt and going to a professional at the end of the day and getting their advice, as well as taking some of the basic information from this video. So what I found out with relation to taxation and cryptocurrency is that it will fall under capital gains tax. Now, what is capital gains tax? Well, we'll just read through this overview. You can go on this website, it's gov.uk, very, very reputable and trustworthy website within the UK. So the information on here, you can be sure assured, is valid information. We'll just go and read through this very quickly. Capital gains tax is a tax on the profit when you sell or dispose of an asset that's increased in value. So let me just give you a very quick example. You can see down here, there's an example. You bought a painting for 5,000, sold it later for 25,000. This means you made a gain of 20,000. 25,000 minus the 5,000 that you originally paid for that painting, and you will get taxed on the gain, which would be the 20,000, not the 25,000, because the gain would be minus your, essentially, your cost of purchase. So let me give you an example relative to Bitcoin. So you go on Coinbase or Gemini or whatever exchange, I don't know, loads of different exchanges, and you buy Bitcoin, right? And you buy Bitcoin, you buy £1,000 worth of Bitcoin, let's say, and you make sure that you keep those records, those transaction details, and I'll get on to record keeping in a minute, but so you make sure you keep those records, you paid £1,000 for X amount of Bitcoin, and then, you know, months go by or a year goes by or whatever, you're just holding that Bitcoin, and, you know, you then decide to cash out. And let's say your Bitcoin is now worth £5,000. Well, when you cash out, obviously, again, you want to keep your records, you want to keep that transaction details, and when you cash out, you will then be taxed on £4,000 worth of that, because it's the £5,000 minus the £1,000 that the Bitcoin actually cost you in the beginning. So, you know, it is quite simple in that respect. So I'm going to go through onto a different page now. So capital gains tax allowances. So I'll just wait for this to load. Here we go. So you can see here, capital gains tax allowances. You only have to pay capital gains tax on your overall gains above your tax-free allowance. So every year you will get a tax-free allowance separate from that of your personal allowance, which is specific to capital gains. So it's your capital gains tax allowance, and that is to the sum of £11,300. So any capital gains up to that amount, you do not have to pay tax on, but you do, and this is where it's some emphasis has to come in, you do have to declare that capital gain, even if let's say you only make £1,000 in capital gains that year, you still need to declare it on the self-assessment tax return. So although you won't have to pay tax on it, you still do need to declare it. But as I say, up until £11,300, that's everyone gets that capital gains tax allowance. There might be some people who won't get it for certain circumstances, but pretty much on an overall basis, everyone gets that £11,300 capital gains allowance. And as I say, as long as you're under that, then you don't you know, you don't necessarily have to pay tax on it, but you do have to declare. So we'll just go into capital gains tax rates on this page here, which is number 7. So you pay a different rate of tax on gains from residential property than you do other assets. So if we come down here, if you pay higher rate income tax, so you'll need to work out whether you're higher rate or basic rate income tax. If you're a higher or additional rate taxpayer, you will pay 28% on your gains from residential property and 20% on your gains from other chargeable assets. And this is the one that will include Bitcoin. So if you're on the higher rate income tax, you will pay 20% of those gains. And if we come down here, if this amount is within the basic income tax band, you'll pay 10% on your gains or 18% on residential property. So if you're in the basic income tax rate, then you'll pay 10% instead of the 20%. So that's what you're going to pay on that gain, on that capital gain. You're going to pay either 10% or 20%. Now, this is the final thing I want to look at, and obviously you guys can come to this page yourself. Hopefully I'll remember to put a link down below and you can have a look around it and all that sort of stuff. So record keeping. You need to collect records to work out your gains and fill in your return, your tax return. You must keep them for at least a year after the self-assessment deadline. You'll need to keep records for longer if you sent your tax return late or HMRC have started to check into your return. Businesses must keep records for 5 years after the deadline. Records you'll need: keep receipts, bills, and invoices that show the date and the amount you paid for an asset. So what you need to do, as I was talking about before, is when you cash into a Bitcoin position, so when you have some Great British Pounds in a bank account and then you buy into Bitcoin, you'll need to keep a transaction receipt for that, or transaction details. You'll need to make sure you've got that somewhere safe. You'll need it to show the date, the amount, all that sort of stuff. And then, you know, while you're holding your Bitcoin or whatever, that's fine. You know, if you're just holding it, that's cool. But then when you come to cash out again, you'll need to have a receipt or transaction details for that cashing out transaction. That's basically that. So you'll need to you'll need to keep it for what you paid for an asset. Any additional costs, so for in this example it says any additional costs like fees for professional advice, stamp duty, improvement costs. So you'll need to again keep a record of the fees on the exchange of what you've paid to go into a Bitcoin position or come out of one. And this also refers to any other cryptocurrency, so it doesn't have to be like Bitcoin. You could be going into a Litecoin position or an Ethereum position or whatever. You know, you still need to keep these records for whatever it is. Also keep any contracts for buying and selling the asset, for example, from solicitors or stockbrokers, and copies of any valuations. If you don't have records, so if you've not provided records, it says here, and I'm just going to take this as given and just read it as it is, you must try to recreate your records if you can't replace them after they've been lost, stolen, or destroyed. So, you know, obviously the best thing you can do is keep records from the offset, because you don't want to be in a position where you're trying to recreate records or something like that. That's not a good position to be in. And, you know, I don't think HMRC are going to like it too much either. I mean, it says it on the website here, on the Gov.UK website, but really get your records straight. Make sure you've got your records sorted. So that's in very basic terms, that's how you will basically get taxed on your Bitcoin, on your capital gains from your Bitcoin or cryptocurrency. Now, you might be thinking, well, how do I do a tax return, and how do I actually file these capital gains? Because let's say you don't have a business, like I have a business, so I do tax returns every year, so I can just include this in the current tax returns I'm doing, and I'll just add it on in a different section. But if you don't know how to do a tax return, you can come on this website and, I mean, you can just search like tax return on this website and it'll give you loads of different information on how to do it and all that sort of stuff. And you can see here, self-assessment tax returns, and you know, it gives you all the information here, and it'll give you information on how to, you know, specifically put capital gains tax in your tax returns. It is a bit complicated at first doing a tax return, but after, you know, after you've done it a couple of times, it took me so long of reading into what it is, how to do it, to really get familiar with it. But once it clicked, it became quite easy. So for me, it's not going to be a hassle including that those capital gains in my yearly tax return. It's not going to be pretty much any trouble at all. I keep records for my business anyway, so it's just an extension of that really. But yeah, I hope you got some information from this video. Again, if anyone has any feedback or you feel that I've been misleading in any way, shape or form in this video, please drop a comment down below. And what I will do is I will add something onto the video, I'll edit the video in some way so that then I've not been misleading in the video. But hopefully I've given you the information that is in front of me, and I've tried to be clear and transparent with you guys of what I have learned. Obviously, as I mentioned in the start of the video, please do seek a professional's advice for 100% accurate you know, advice, obviously. But I'll leave it there, guys. Thank you for joining me, and I will see you in my next video. So see you very soon, guys.